Welcome back to New Day Cleveland. Coming up in this half hour, booties, ripped jeans, and lace, the staples that every woman should have in her closet this fall. Plus, have you heard of juice cleansing? I'm going to beat you up, Neil. It's supposed to help you detoxify your body, maybe even lead to weight loss. Coming up, we're talking to Dr. Mark to get the truth. He has me all messed up over here. Even though it's September, it is still fair season here in Ohio. Welcome, Neil Zurcher, with today's one tank trip. Before we get to that, this one is over here reading my prompter as if he were me. And I can't help but laugh.
I can't read, except I have to use my mouth. I'm going to...
He's reading my script with me.
I hear you had a slider last week.
I did.
Really? Was it good?
It was. And you know what? We're talking about White Castle sliders.
Yeah, John Ackerman took you over.
John Ackerman took me to White Castle. It was the first time I've ever had White Castle food.
That's the first time.
I swear it was. Oh, so he videotapes me while we're in the car. Oh, you saw it?
I saw it on Facebook.
So I say in it, you know, oh, it's good. You know, the bun's bigger
that
than the actual patty.
That wasn't an overwhelming endorsement you gave it.
It wasn't, I guess, and White Castle thought the same. And White Castle called me out and said, it's
did
not.
Did they really?
Oh, they did. They said, it's not good. It's great. Or no, they said, it's not. It's better than good. It's great. But they were very sweet, because then I responded to them saying that it was really delicious and I did want to get more when I was done.
I'm glad that you got it. Hey, White Castles, I don't think, are at the county fair, but that's
they
where we
have
went
any
this
there?
Past
okay.
week. The Geauga County Fair is over with. It's done for the year, but it's one of the greatest fairs in Ohio. And, you know, there's a lot of fairs still ahead we'll talk about in a moment, but today's one tank trip. We're going to the fair.
Sounds good to me.
It's just about 40 miles from downtown Cleveland to bucolic Burton, Ohio, and the home of the great Geauga County Fair. Each August, September, and October is county fair time in Ohio. It's a time for all of us to return to our agricultural roots by attending a county fair. The Great Geauga County Fair is Ohio's oldest continuous operating fair. It's been going since 1823. A country fair is animals, food, farm equipment. Where else can you see chicken flying contests?
Oh.
Why do people come to county fairs?
I think it's the atmosphere. I think, especially here in Geauga County, we really push the agricultural point of it. The county is, you know, has a strong agricultural heritage. The 4-H, the kids, it's all about the kids.
Candy apples. Homemade garlic brats and apple dumplings with ice cream and cinnamon sauce.
Lemonade.
Oh, the french fries are so popular, they make you want to slap your grandma.
And the food. At the Geauga County Fair, they have an annual apple pie baking contest. Best of all, an auction to sell off most of the runners-up.
You enter a pie, an apple pie.
Anybody can enter.
Anybody can enter. They have different age groups and prizes for each age group. The pies are then judged, and you know they have winners in each division, and then a grand champion. Yeah, we have judges that judge them, and then they award the prizes, and then Saturday afternoon we have an auction, and we auction off the pies.
And let's not forget those deep-fried, slathered in sugar, dipped in syrup delicacies that you can only find right here at a county fair.
Elephant ears, because they're so sugary.
Corn dogs.
And of course, it wouldn't be a fair without the animals and all the winners' ribbons and trophies that they're competing for.
278, you're up. 295 is on deck. 144.
Sam, how many different categories are there for the animals here?
Oh boy, I'd have to count them, but you've got everything from ducks to rabbits, chickens, turkeys, goats, hogs, sheep, miniature horses, llamas, alpacas, draft horses, draft ponies.
What does it mean to win the grand championship? Now, you know, because your sons won.
Well, it means you're the best of the best that day. Especially for the 4-H kids, it's a culmination of the whole year. My son was grand champion about 3 years ago, and he set the record, and a buyer stepped up and paid $40 a pound.
$40
a pound? Which equated to a little over $10,000 for his hog, which greatly increased his college fund.
Someone once described the fair to me as like a circus, a family reunion, and a giant sales convention that all came to town on the very same day. And between now and the 1st of October, you can still have a chance to attend about 21 different fairs all around the Buckeye State. Just go to our Fox 8 website for a listing of where and when.
All right, looks like our main team is about ready to go.
One of the things you really like about county fairs is almost all of them have something that's very unique. Like here at the Great Geauga County Fair, it's pig races.
The track is clear, the cookie's down, the pigs are loaded, and the pig's gonna be number 4, criminal hog. Number 4, criminal hog.
You know, they've written songs, they've written books, they've even written movies about America's country fairs. Try one, I think you'll like it. And best of all, it's just a one tank trip. I'm Neil Zurcher, and AAA will help you find the way. Do you know what makes a pig race?
Or what they race for? No, I was just going to ask you, what in the heck made them want to run around that track? What
enticed them? Oreo cookies.
Oreo cookies.
They have an Oreo cookie at the end, and these pigs take off, and they'll go crazy for an Oreo cookie. I didn't know. So I'd go crazy for an Oreo cookie.
Do they have
cookie.
Some milk for them, too?
I don't think so.
Oh, just
cookies. That's too
cookies.
Bad. It's probably just swill. Isn't that what pigs eat? I mean, incidentally, the whole reason we did this story in the fair, even though we know it was last week and it's over with, folks, I'm sorry you can't go right now. There are about 20 other county fairs around the state in our viewing area that are still yet to come between now and the end of October.
What's your favorite fair food?
My favorite
Besides Oreo
fair
cookies.
Food other than Erie. I'll tell you, out here at the Geauga County Fair, we had a Sloppy Joe sandwich that was probably one of the best. And it was very inexpensive. It was like $2.50, which kind of surprised me for fair food.
Yeah.
What's yours?
Funnel cake.
Funnel cake.
Funnel cake.
That's just fried dough.
I know, but they make them so good at the
They're
fairs.
Good, yeah, aren't they, though? They're I
so
love fair
good.
Food. Really
that and meatballs. There was one place,
yeah.
Gosh, I'm forgetting the name of it, but it's
Jefferson
so good.
Jefferson County Fair.
Mm-hmm. It was very, very good meatballs.
Near Steubenville.
Yes, I've been there too.
Yes. I heard you had.
Neil, how about swordfish at a fair?
I love swordfish. Just give me swordfish, I'll eat it any day.
All right. Well, I'm guessing they don't have that at the fair, you know, but you can get it while it's hot, that's for sure. Harpoon caught swordfish from Nova Scotia has made its way to Whole Foods.